everyone, and welcome back to Dragaria Lost. So we have, of course, a new month coming up today, so we got this month in Dragaria Lost. Usually I don't do it since they are minimal news, but since we are approaching an anniversary, I wanted to cover what was discussed in this month, and also tease a bit about what is coming next, since we will have a Dragaria Digest at the end of the month, likely September 27th, around that date, since that is when the anniversary really starts. So let's go into the news section to see what we have to discuss. And here it is. We have, of course, the usual recap for this month. Won't take too much time on this, but I just wanted to tell you that this week we will have the Agents of the Goddess event story and the Agido Uprising event story compilation. What is the Agido Uprising event story compilation? Basically, since we cleared the Tartarus of a video, and I also have recorded an attempt that went well, so I will also make an extra video next week, however, for a Tartarus Summer Claw attempt with an all-light team that went really well. We have all the stories for each Agido. I will start with Volk, then Kayan, then Ciella, then the Twins, then Tartarus, and then there is a finale. So it is like an event story, if you will, but with the bonus of being all about the Agido. Then, of course, we have the next week, which should be some downtime, plus on Friday we should have the next defensive battle. I think it is on Friday, because the event should end on the 11th, if I'm not wrong. So then we should have the next defensive battle, which we will check out later, we have some info about it. After the Agido, we have, of course, the new Gacha. I covered Nevin and Pino on Adventure Stories, if you want to go check them out. I haven't pulled Ramiel or Thor, but I have made a Shulyu pull into the Gacha video, if you want to check out whether they are good or not. I can tell you that Galador is actually really, really good. Plans for this month, now the interesting part. Mana Spirals for the Light Arcane Adventurers, Estelle, Luca and Lucrecia will be unlocked tomorrow. So we have Estelle with a healer, not really used that much, but since we have only Hildegard as a decent healer for Light, maybe she will see some play for people that didn't manage to get Hildegard. We have Luca, who is a free adventurer, so you will likely get a really good Mana Spiral. Also remember that you have already unlocked Luca's skill share, so if you upgrade him for his Mana Spiral, it's likely that you will get a good result. And then we have Lucrecia, who is probably one of the top picks for the Mana Spiral, since she has a really good interaction with Galador, since she's all about Energize, and she'll probably see a really good Mana Spiral for most players that want to clear Tartarus with Galador. So, Shulyu Spiral, right here I'd say by the preview I can tell you that Luca and Lucrecia likely will have a really good Mana Spiral, since one is free and the free Mana Spiral so far have been really good. Ranzal Mana Spiral is a commonly one of the best because of his skill share. Cleo Mana Spiral is widely used. The Prince Mana Spiral, back when it released, was one of the top picks for the Agido. I expect Luca Mana Spiral to follow the same idea. Lucrecia, as I said earlier, is heavily linked with Galador, so if you pull the Galador and have Lucrecia, I see no reason not to check out her Mana Spiral and do it. For Estelle, I guess I will have to hold my judgment and check it out later on. Next, a defensive event will be held in mid-September. A certain pair will play a big role, and the story will focus on the secret of their origins. You'll be able to use the autoplay feature on beginner, standard and expert to play through maps that are designed to be played without much hassle. Also, starting with this event, Japanese voices will be added to defensive events. The story in Onslaught events and defensive events is a bit different from the story in the main campaign, raid events and facility events, so I'm hopeful that the addition of voice dialogue will draw players even further into the storytelling. Ok, so this is interesting because he only mentions defensive event for the VO. I hope that it is both for defensive and Onslaught, but I think we might be in a raid only for defensive one, which is fine, I guess. Having at least one voice makes up for less work for me for replacing the music, but also a more enjoyable experience for you guys watching or of course playing. Remember to always play this way better than watching videos, I feel like. But I am here to cover those guys that cannot play, like I did back some years ago when I didn't have decent PC or a decent phone. So the interesting part here is the tease about who is going to be in this defensive event. A certain pair, so it is someone that we already know. And the story will focus on the secrets of their origins. So there are secrets, stuff that we don't know. I thought about this a little bit while I was making this video. And my two ideas about it are two characters that we have not seen at all in the story, but they appeared in an interlude in the main story fairly recently in chapter 12, I think. Go check it out if you haven't seen it. It is Wake and Karina. So Wake is a three-star character, bow, I think. Let me show you guys since we have time and this isn't a video that I really need to worry about. So Wake is right here. So Wake was teased to be a prince from the north based on his personal story and also his appearance in this interlude that I was talking about, and we know nothing else about it. We know that he was driven away from his homeland, so we don't know why, we don't know where is his homeland, in the north most likely, since the interlude is that. And in this interlude, while he was singing this song from his country, we see that Karina recognizes the song and also appreciates it because it is from her homeland. It is guessed that her homeland is also in the north, and the interaction between those two characters makes me think that they are both from the north. She also has a little mention in these descriptions where she loves how the sea allows her not to be tied down, as that was once a problem in her past. So my guess is that she also was a princess or something similar that couldn't have much freedom. The other pair that I feel like could be in this defensive event is Veriga and Navid. So why? Because of this Wyrmthrint, if I manage to find it, should be right about here, I think, if I don't remember wrong, because okay, there it is. So they both haven't had much interaction. However, in this Wyrmthrint we see them together and we also see this description. The sweet aroma of sandalwood, the refreshing taste of exotic fruit, surrounded by smells and tastes of home, they swear anew to fight for peace. So, I don't think they knew each other, but they are from the same country. They have the same sort of style in their clothes and mannerism, if you will. And I look forward to finding out who we get. Could also be Akasha and Heidwald, like Yashiro and Musashi, who knows. I personally think it's going to be Wake and Karina. It's my first guess, based on the stuff that we had recently, the focus on the north of Grestea and other stuff. But that's it for the defensive event. More will be found out next week for sure. Let's move on. A revival of the Fractured Futures raid event will be held in late September. We knew this was coming since what else could have been rerun before the anniversary. And if you guys don't know, Fractured Futures has actually been featured already in the channel. You have bought the story, the free adventure story, and also the boss fights, all of them. I managed to clear Kronos Nyx EX back when it released, Omega rather, not EX. A really tough fight, and the idea here is that I want to take down the old story videos and one new one where I put the story all in one video, because back then it was kinda scuffed. So having the story, which is really really good, inside one video with all the extra stuff that I had, the background, the chapters, the music replacement and so on, will make for a better experience for sure. I will also look into re-uploading Odric's story with the same adjustments, since I had to mute some parts and I did it in the brute way, where it's kinda the bad way of YouTube, where the audio is really really scuffed. So that's the plan for this event. Everything else I will leave up, the fights I will leave up, because I can't replicate the fight like it was back then. Why? Back then we had a different meta, we had a really less powerful character. I didn't have High Dragon Trial weapon, I didn't have a Guido or Chimera Tech weapons. So I feel like that was the true experience to clear Kronos Nyx. It took me a ton of time and it was probably one of the most enjoyable boss battles that I did in a really really long time for any game. So go check it out if you want to see it. The audio will be kinda scuffed, but I can assure you that it is an enjoyable experience. The event debuted last year as a part of the first anniversary celebration. Now that it's coming back, you have a chance to add the event exclusive Odric and Dragon Parallel Zodiac to your team if you haven't already. I have, but it's fine. This event provides a close look into the heart of the Dragalia Lost story and setting, so I hope those of you, yes, check it out, get your free Odric, it's really good, and also Parallel Zodiac, since it has a really cool dragon story that I can't wait to cover in the future, for sure. An interlude will be added to chapter 15 of the main campaign in late September, as usual, looking forward to that as well. Master difficulty for Ciella, the Water Tomb Boss of the Akita Uprising, early October, so they delayed it to give the space to the anniversary. I don't really have a setup for Master Ciella, so I don't look forward to doing it, but I will try as I did for the Vast Bosses. Dragalia Lost will celebrate its second anniversary on September 27, as I said earlier. Like the first, we have celebratory events, including a late event related to the main story, which we knew is a follow-up to Fractured Futures, so make sure to check out the Fractured Futures story. Playing through the recently added Chapter 15 will ensure that you're caught up to the latest story beats and can enjoy this event to the fullest. The Chapter 15 story is also up to the channel if you haven't caught up, but remember to do it, since I feel like it is better also to experience it. We're working on more than just the story, look forward to getting up against a new raid boss too. That's good, I always love if they give us all new raid boss, which means that they don't reuse the model. So, not much to say here, we will cover this in the Dragalia Digest video if I had to guess, since this is just a tease to say that we will probably get the Dragalia Digest on the week of the 27th, either before or after that, and then I will cover it for sure. Future updates, now this is the interesting part. Since the next update will be released during the second anniversary, we plan to implement a variety of adjustments and existing features to existing features and add new ones while addressing game balance. So we get balance and new features, nice. Included in these changes will be large scale adjustment to the balance of adventurers, dragons and weapons, which is something that the game needed because of course of Shadow. Shadow is vastly overpowered, it has tainted all the other Aghido fights. If you try to get a team for Tartarus right now, it is hard because most of the players are trying to do some weird shadow strategy, and also this is a rant rather than a complaint, but they want the run to be perfect, so if you mess up one little thing, they don't retry, they just leave, which is probably one of the most annoying things because they added the retry feature just to give you guys a chance to adjust to the fight, even though you are trying with the strategy with the Shadow, but that's okay. At the moment, the damage output and skill performance of Shadow at an Adventurers, of course, is stronger than those of other elements. The team player to prioritize their inclusion in team, regardless of whether or not Shadow has the elemental advantage in a particular quest. We don't feel the damage and skill performance need to be completely equal across all 5 elements, sure. We recognize that Shadow at an Adventurers are noticeably stronger than their counterparts at this time, they sure are. To address this imbalance, we plan to adjust the other 4 elements so they perform at a similar high standard. We may have to adjust the strength of enemies alongside these changes, but we'll take care not to alter the current campaign experience too much. These balance adjustments will be implemented in update in late September. Ok, so this is probably the best way to adjust it, why? Because when you nerf something in a gacha game, people get understandably pissed, because you say, I spent $5,000 on Galalex, now you nerf her, and I didn't use my money for what you told me I would receive. And this happened in World Flipper, another gacha from Cygames, and in a ton of other gachas, where people rightfully complain because nerfing something always means that you are giving less value to those who spent for your gacha. So buffing other characters instead makes sense, because it's not like you are making them better than Galalex, you are making them at the same level or less, which is understandable for those who have Galalex, for example like me, who want to use other adventurers for their respective elemental content. My skeptical side hopes that this doesn't mean that they make some characters really really OP, because we already have mana spirals, How would you plan to buff them? Will you add a progressive damage alongside all elements? Like, for example, for light and water, who are the weakest elements, you give them a significant buff. For fire and wind, you give them a slight buff so that they pair up with the Gala Alex meta. How will they plan to do this? I'm not sure yet. I guess that we will have to see. I am hopeful, since they recognize the right way to do this. And hopefully it fixes this problem, since with the last Aghido it is rampant in the game, and I am tired of playing Gala Alex in every fight, which I don't. I just do it in Kayan. For other elements, I still plan to use the respective elements, since otherwise it's not fun to me. It's not fun to play Gala Alex against every boss in this game. Like, why am I even farming for the weapons if I'm not using them? You know, that's the main point that I think about when I use main element characters. The weapon system will be made easier to understand in the next update. Currently there are tons of weapons player can craft. Don't tell me about it, I have 250 different weapons by now. And figuring out which ones to make can be confusing. The player also obtain weapons as rewards, but often there is not space for them. Player could dismantle those weapons, but that can be a frustration as well. In the next update, we'll adjust the way weapons are obtained and upgraded with the aim of alleviating the above concerns. Since this will be a large departure from the current system, we'll provide further delay in a notification before the update is released. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I am really stressed out about managing my weapon bug, because every time I get those 55 star locked weapon and I get tired by clicking every time to remove the lock, then having to dismantle it, remove it, and so on. Then we got the Chimera deck, who you can't dismantle, and they sit there and they are pointless. So, a rework was sorely needed, and hopefully it is a good rework. I can't wait for this one will probably be the best one, but overall we got our upgrade for all the system, which I'm really happy about. Hopefully it doesn't change the game too much, because then it ends like Dragon Ball Legends, where I was a really good player, then I got trashed really quickly. So hopefully it is something that I look forward to, and I hope that it is done in the right way. In addition to what I've got here, we have a Dragalia Digest in late September. Okay, now, few things. So, the timeline, let's do this before we go on to something else. We have early September, mid September, late September, end of the month. So we have 4 weeks in September and then half a week at the end. This week we don't get anything but the mana spirals. Next week we have the defensive event. When it ends, the week after, it should start with the the rerun for the Fracture Futures. So let's do the math here. If the event next event starts on the 11th, so it is a Friday, then we have the rerun starts on a Monday and it lasts until the 23rd. The Dragalia Digest plus the update should be around the 23rd-24th, if I had to guess. Then we have on the 27th the anniversary event that should start on the 28th alongside the new Gala Dragalia. So we have a pretty stacked month, it doesn't seem that we have any break or whatsoever. And on the 3rd of this month, actually, we have another thing, we have the trial battles for the current event that I will cover on the channel. It is a shadow, so nothing much difficult, but I will do it anyway. I expect the Dragalia Digest to be on the 24th, if I'm honest with you, or the 25th will be the same, it is still late September for them. So to recap, 7th to 13th is mid-September, 14th to 20th is... no, sorry. 7th to 13th is still early September, 14th to 20th is mid-September, 21 to 27th is late September, 28th to 30th is end of the month. That's usually how they go with by dates. Okay, so that's all that we had to cover, I guess. Nothing else to say. Most of the stuff that I want to go deeper in will be covered in the Dragalia Digest, so it doesn't make much sense to go say anything else. So next, as I said earlier, for the channel we have the Agents of the Goddess story and the Aghido compilation coming up. I decide which to get first, probably the Agents of the Goddess will come first tomorrow. Hopefully you guys enjoy this month for Dragaria Lost. It is the most hype month coming up. Hopefully we get some interesting adventures from this anniversary. I have a ton of resources to pull. I get 5 10 star tickets, 20 full tickets, and 1800 wirmets, so enough to do a decent enough job in the coming Ashes. Thank you very much for joining me. Hopefully you enjoyed this coverage of this month in Dragalia Lost, and hopefully you enjoyed the news that we have to cover. You remember, if you enjoy the channel or other stuff, to leave a like and a sub, and hopefully I will see you next time, or probably next week, for an Agiro Battle coverage with the Summer Clive and Tartarus, and of course the Gash. Thank you very much once again, look forward for the story this week. Until Lodge, peace out.